Happy Good Friday. This is Amy Nichols Madison,
Mary Kay Lady, actor, and practicing redhead.
Ooh. Been doing some stuff today.
Shampooing carpet. My dog, does this happen to you?
My dog does the scoot butt thing in my bedroom.
In my bedroom, right in front of me. He'll look me in the eye and go,
whatever, whatever on your
cleanliness. Let's see if you see it. Oh, that's better. Okay.
Today we're doing soft pinks.
Now there's a likelihood this look is just going to be more subtle than I want. And tonight doing a Good Friday service.
And yesterday I taught at the preschool in my church. And they did the Easter egg hunt. And some of those little ones,
you know, I was
worried they would get lost in the shuffle
hunting for the eggs.
These two little girls, and I would
be like, here it is, here it is. Man,
30 seconds in, they were like,
They picked up on that. They were like, there is some candy and stuff coming for me, and I want to have it. And I was like, good for you, good for you. So I've got my eye primer on, following it up with face primer. It takes a
little bit for the primer to set,
a couple minutes, so then we switch over to do eyebrows
and let the eye primer set.
So why should we do primers? Primers help keep the makeup on. It keeps makeup from coming out in the crevices. It's another layer of SPF if you use mine. Good stuff. And we don't want eye makeup to run, smudge. This look today is a little delicate, so I look forward to trying it. But I don't want it to just run into one shade of pink. I would like to be able to see the different colors.
Taking the eyebrow pencil, the precision liner. So, my dog, when he loves on me, he does this prairie dog thing.
And he is a large dog. And today he was pawing at me and got my chin. So, that's
one thing. Yeah, he got my chin. So, I did get a new Easter dress. Did you get a new Easter dress? I think everybody should. I have to wear my choir robe on Easter, so I'm like boo to that, but
I'll make sure I get extra time walking around. Ooh, look what I got, look what I got.
Do you get yourself a new Easter dress?
Even if you're not going to church, maybe you're going to a really fabulous brunch.
And if so, what colors, you know, what colors? Mine is white and green. I like to do a lot of green because, again, practicing redhead. And I can bring my white shoes out.
Still going to use black when I want to. Man, those rules, I
still, my grandmother taught me those rules.
She had a clothing shop called Just Petites.
And those rules of you have to wear brown with brown.
Brown, you know, you can't combine brown shoes with a black shirt or a black belt, and to this day I cannot. I wore brown
clogs with a black outfit, and I walked around like
I was like, please, no one notice. But
the kids these days, they don't care. So that was eyebrow tint,
which I love. It thickens the lash. I mean, the eyebrow hair.
That doesn't sound right, but it's gonna be.
All right, so now I'm going to take under eye corrector. Love our under eye corrector. It's all peach in color because the discoloration on and around the eye is bluish in nature.
So I'm going to pat. Actually, I should be using the ring finger.
You're patting it around.
Yeah, and a lot of people, when they
try this on, all of a sudden they see such a big difference.
And those bags, it will cover those up. Now, of course, I have a bunch of stuff that won't just cover it up, but will, let me turn you up. That won't just cover it up, but will help to work on the puffiness and eye cream. But that's okay, this is what we're using today.
Those other stuff are for the other skincare videos I will make. So let's see, Mary Kay Liquid Eyeshadow in Pink Starlight. All over the eyelids and up to the creases. Okay.
Here's the pink starlight. It has a DOFA applicator on it, which makes it very easy to apply. If you are having a time fitting, you know, putting a look onto your business, this will do ya. And pushing that color up into the crease like it tells me to. This is a pretty quick look. We'll see what I think of it. I haven't made my choices yet. Next, we're going to buff and blend edges using eyeshadow in Dusty Rose. Okay, that's what we're gonna do. Hi. We're putting Dusty Rose on. I don't know. Is this one gonna work out? I don't know. I just put a whole lot of color on there. Ah! Well, even though it doesn't tell me to, I'm gonna put some Dusty Rose down here. Because I'm a rebel. A maverick, if you will. Alright, let's get some of this. Let's take the smudge brush, clean it off a little. And I'm gonna blend down into the pink. Let's see how this goes. And a little bit up, but mostly down into the pink. But like I've been doing lately, I'm doing the crease by coming up above it since I have hooded eyelids. And this is something you can do too, even if you have your single-lidded. Ella is single-lidded. What do I think? I don't know yet. Let me try. Put more on! Okay, maybe so. Kind of 80s in nature. I used to love to wear pink in the 80s all the time. So now it says take candlelight. I love candlelight. I love that color. And pat it over the pink. I love it when they do that, when they suggest that you add. But then what I do in the center of the eyelid. Okay. Kind of bring out, do it in the center. What do we think? Unfortunately, we can add if we don't like it. Now, it is asking me to do cat eye. Let's see how we do. Sometimes that'd be good, but I'm gonna do my tight lining first. I just love how it looks. And you can, you know, you can definitely stop with the tight lining, but I'm gonna attempt to do cat eye for it. Sometimes cat eye cat eye's not for everybody. So I'm tight lining by coming underneath the lash, and yes, I'm kind of touching my eyeball. If that grosses you out, don't do this. I've been wearing contacts since 1980-something, so I'm used to just rubbing my finger all over my eyeball. Okay.
There we go.
I'm going to go back here and take the, we're calling it liquid eyeliner? Yeah, liquid eyeliner pen. We're just going to work. If this is a trouble for you, if doing eyeliner is a problem. See, look how I'm doing that. I'm doing it to the side. I'm not doing it this way. I'm letting the point and the side of it do the job. It's a little less nerve-wracking. So, going to go a little beyond, just a little bit. For some cat eye. Just a little bit, not much. There we go. Pretty good. I feel good about it. Of course, now I have to mess with it, and I may mess it up. That's okay. There we go. Now, what do I think of it so far? I don't know. I'm going to go ahead and do the foundation step. We haven't talked about it yet. If you are outside a lot in the summer, in the spring and summer, it could be time for you to get a new shade of foundation. And I love to do that. Once you work with me and you've got your foundations coming from me, I keep track of all of those. Because if there's anything that's frustrating, it's trying to buy foundation. From a grocery store, and even sometimes from a department store, the light
in there is not the best, and you can shade match a little, but the thing about working with me is once we send a shade matching kit, or you know, if you're in the Austin area, come by, then we match you with a couple of different ones. But you don't ever have to go and see, man, that was the biggest deal with me. I'm so glad I do Medicano, because going and getting that little bottle from the grocery store and coming home and going, well, this isn't right. So you know what you do. We all do it. We all did it. We go ahead and wear it anyway with that base liner. Not good. Not good at all. So what do we think of the pink so far? I kind of like it. I need to see it all completely done. Okay. You all know about this that I'm constantly having to cover up. Finally, gotten off my ass and called the dermatologist. And I will share with you what they tell me about it. You know, apparently it's safe, but, you know, there is someone in my family who had a blemish that turned out to be a big deal. And that's on the brain. That's on the brain. So we're going to do blush, a combination of blush and blaze, apple of the cheek. So a combination, kind of making the blush a little more sparkly. So there we go. We're going to take some of the highlighter and come on the top here. Then take some and put it at the end of the nose. Taking that same blush and coming to either side. The kids taught me this. Now I'm going to blend a little more. Just kind of working those lines. I think I'm liking it. I really didn't think I would. Oh, shoot. Now we're going to powder. Well, am I going to powder down? I'm going to do my old trick. This is medium nude. I'm going to do my old trick of putting lip liner on first and powdering that down. It kind of works to stain the lip, so even though I might go eat and drink, I'm still going to have pigment on my lips. So I kind of come in a little bit, and let's powder down now. This was a quick look, wasn't it? Sometimes the good stuff, it can happen like that. All right, translucent loose powder. What I like about the translucent loose powder is it's perfectly translucent. You can match any skin tone because it doesn't have a shade. So I'm going to get that little boo-boo down there. Yeah, teaching preschool again, they look at this blemish here on my chest and they're like, do you remember how it is with little ones? They are obsessed with their boo-boos. So I have this intense boo-boo right here. And they're like, Mrs. Madison, are you okay? And I'm like, let's take a look at that. Let's get these lashes curled out. Remember to curl before you put your mascara on so you don't yank all of your eyelashes out of your face. I'm going to do a couple of coats of my favorite, Fanarama. I love it. The formula is all the same we use, but it's the applicator. It's the brush, the bristles. And what I love about this one is it's got bristles on the end that really help you get in there and work it. So, you know, getting the bottom here, sometimes I don't love it the way I put it on the bottom, so I love to clean it up at the end here. What I love about my formula of mascara is it's so smooth, I can come back in, you know, headed to church tonight, and I can put another coat on, and it doesn't clump. It is. So what have we learned today? We've learned that if you want foundation that actually matches your face and mascara that is non-clumping, check me out. www.marykay.com/AmyNicholsMadison. Get in there. Do some shopping. Oh, so good. And we're going to end it with, I had several options but it wants Fancy Nancy.
And I can't deny Fancy Nancy, because I'm fancy, even though I'm not Nancy. It'll be made to be a little richer. It's a pretty safe, well, hello. It's pretty, it's kind of translucent in itself, so that's why I add the lip liner. I can let the hair down now. I need to tell you, I haven't let my hair down in a couple of days because it's just this big loaf. It's like I'm my own chia pet. So let's try that. Then I'm going to go fix it and get ready so I'll be ready for church tonight. Ooh, this is not a good hair reveal. Let me take So, I am working towards getting my red jacket back. So what does that mean? I have a goal. I need to add two more excited folks to my team to get my red jacket back in time for seminar. If you would like, be willing to be one of my guinea pigs and let me practice my presentation, I would be so grateful. So if you would, message me and let me know, and I will have a gift for you. So we're back at MaryKay.com /Amy Nichols Madison. If you want to know all of this, I will add the links to all of these cosmetics in the description of the video. And this will go up on YouTube in a few minutes.